You cover Sector 2. Repair any equipment you come across.
Affirmative.
Anthony, you're Sector 3. I'll leave it to you to decide whether plasma guns are called for.
All right.
James, check out the control bridge. Our communication issues might be the result of electrical interference.
Yes, sir.
And KG, run a complete sweep of the residential quarters and investigate any trace of survivors.
Got it.
Each of you is authorized to use a freeze gun. Do not forget to check in regularly via navigation booths. And Samus, you go to the system management room. Do everything you can to get the electrical system back up and running. Looks like your comm system is still functional. Remember, everything you see will also appear on this screen. Regarding auxiliary weapons, the use of bombs has been authorized. As far as your other weapons go, we will continue to investigate and authorize use as we can. However, we currently have no plans to authorize the use of power bombs. As you know, they have the ability to spread a high-temperature heat wave over a large area, impacting living things, which is a nice way of saying they can vaporize humans instantly. You should be well aware of how dangerous power bombs are and how their devastation can't be obstructed with common materials. Once the mission in the system management room is complete, I need you to report back. I'll give you your next orders then. I want you all to be especially careful as you execute your missions. That's the end of the briefing.
It was the first joint mission I've been a part of since becoming a freelance bounty hunter. And of course, it was the first time since my Federation days that I was following the orders of a commanding officer. Having received mission orders from Adam, I felt confused and strangely exhilarated at the unexpected turn of events. I responded.
Understood, Adam. No objections, of course.
Samus, head for the system management room.